There are great ideas. The technology would be fantastic, but it's a process that defines whether that would be successful or not. If it can be inculcated at an early age, now they know not only to solve the problem, but also how to address the market and how to make their product successful. You feel a part of the company, then obviously you advocate that company and you love to work for that company.
Today you could be nobody, tomorrow you could become somebody, and the somebody can be done by brand. Today I'm very excited to meet and interview a person who has over 15 years of experience working in technical domain as well as in branding domain. He's presently working at Cisco. We welcome you to the talk of STEAM Education, sir.
Thanks, Santosh.
We have created several technological companies and several ideas get mushroomed into a startup, and unfortunately many of them die soon. Do you think one of the reasons behind why they don't take off very well or don't sustain for longer is it because of non-introduction of STEAM at a very early age?
Yeah, this is a very practical problem that we are seeing. And as you know, Bangalore has a lot of startups, and we see a lot of startups coming up, flourishing, getting acquired, and we have seen lot more startups which fail. And the whole thing that I would attribute this to is the process. Everybody has a great idea and there is a solution for a problem that they try to solve. There are great ideas, the technology would be fantastic, but it's a process that defines whether that would be successful or not. I'll take a simple example. Let me take a McDonald's, okay? You have seen McDonald's across continents, right? And it has been flourishing in all. What they have special in them, they have defined a well-defined process. They have a clear vision, mm-hmm. what they want to serve. And they have a clear defined process. Okay, this is the sequential process that I would follow, and this is the how I would reach my vision, correct? And that actually defines which business would be successful and which startup would flourish and which startups will actually make it to the end.
So
as a global change.
Yeah, as you rightly put, I think it's not just important that you know how to make a good burger, but it's also important that you make that rich burger in everyone's hand. And that is what we're talking about, the process, which also involves a amount of branding. So so does it mean, is that tinkering or learning early age could help us, you know, getting the process? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yes, the problem solving, mm-hmm. is one part, and conveying like what is the problem that you're solving and influencing others to understand there is a problem in the first place is what helps to inculcate, like the STEM education. It's not only you're trying to solve a problem, but you're also branding yourself to solve that problem. Like, this is the steps that I'm following, and this is the problem that I'll be solving, and this is what will serve the purpose. So that creates a brand awareness, and that is the branding that you're giving to the end customer, correct? It can be inculcated at an early age. Now they know not only to solve the problem, but also how to address the market and how to make their product successful.
Wonderful. We put very rightly in a right spirit that I think tinkering could really help at a very early age. You have a very vast experience and forte and expertise in branding at Cisco. Why do you think employees at times are not very vocal about or being proud of the companies where they work for?
Yep. It all starts with the appreciation, I would say, like how you are being recognized in your organization. Like, companies actually treat their employees, appreciate whatever they are doing, and they also create a personal touch with their families. That all becomes an inclusiveness in their work culture. Okay, so when an environment is created in such a way that you are inclusive as part of that company and you feel a part of the company, then obviously you advocate that company and you love to work for that company. If that is being done, it's a pure win-win game. So the companies, it's like our children, correct? When our children try to do something new and we try to encourage them And this goes a long way where they try to improvise on it, and then they try to bring better things out of them, correct? Okay. Mm-hmm. So that inclusiveness, what you bring across for the kids at an early stage, that's when even it grows up as in their DNA, in their culture. Okay. And when they become bigger and they lead an organization or they are part of an organization, mm-hmm. they'll feel very proud of doing what they are doing.
Yeah, I have an interesting question to ask again between, so do you see any relation between the branding and the STEAM coming together for the people to become a little vocal about where they work, what do they do, and feel proud about it?
As I already said, like if you make the people very vocal, what they are doing, and emphasize like what is that is important for them, at early stages, then branding automatically comes in. It's very natural that comes in out over there. Mm-hmm. And the STEAM education actually helps to inculcate that into the kids from a very early age. Mm-hmm.